but she can't convince herself of her own detachment. When you see into someone's mind, read their thoughts, you become indelibly connected to them. Their tragedies are your tragedies. She leafs through the next few pages, wanting more, afraid that this could be the last entry. No, it continues. Everything didn't end in 1918. Kathy has more to say.
January 1st, 1919. Another January. So much can happen in a year. It's painful to look back at the words I wrote at the beginning of this century. I had such hope then, such ambitions. It was only 19 years ago, and yet I cannot recognise the girl I was then. How naive I was, how foolish to imagine that my life would proceed as smoothly and easily as it had done up to then. When I was 15, the world had so much promise. And now look at it. Ernest was shot on his first day in France. The letter from his commanding officer says it was instant, he wouldn't have felt a thing. I have since begun to wonder if he was just being kind. We have all learned how to ease the blows by wrapping them up prettily. My sisters, too, are now widows. The head of every family except Reginald, Diana's husband, killed in action. Reginald was wounded and patched up in hospital in France. His letters describe that hospital with such painful detail. Blood accumulating on the floor in puddles. The abandonment of those not thought likely to survive. The piles of body parts. The smell. And he must have been the one who brought the Spanish flu home to us, but I can't find it in my heart to blame him. He died too within a few weeks of his return. It was a blessing. His pain was terrible to witness. Beatrice, Diana, Ethel, Fanny and I have survived. Alice volunteered to work in a hospital in France, set up by the Duchess of Sutherland. How could people so casually and unkindly refer to her as Meddlesome Millie, when she was such an ardent champion of social reform? Do they have no shame? Just because the establishment doesn't like the way she challenged the status quo,